What is domestic violence in the eyes of DCF in Massachusetts? Domestic violence in the eyes of DCF takes on many different flavors, sizes, shapes, and forms. That includes the obvious, where one person hits another person, which is physical abuse, and would also be connotated as being neglect, because a child or children may see such an incident of physical violence between two partners that are intimate. And therefore, the viewing of that physicality would be neglect, as it has a very harmful effect on children. Other types of the domestic violence are verbal in nature, where there's threats or some type of conduct and behavior that's just not acceptable towards one another, especially when we're intimate partners, such as taking somebody's keys so they can't leave the house or drive their car, taking control of the finances so the person can't go and do what they want to do, controlling that person's movement through financial or through the holding of their keys or taking their cell phone. Another example. The other types is where somebody controls the person's whereabouts, saying you can't be with that person, you can't be with this person. There is many different types of domestic violence that occur in our society. Each and every one is different because each and every person involved in that relationship is different. There is no one size fits all. There's no one shoe that can be put into a woman or a man's foot. Or, I didn't like that, because you could have gay couples and stuff. You know what I'm saying? So you can't say man or woman.
I'm just going to keep it going. You can
Go ahead. Whenever.
Just stop him whenever. Before we do, though, just remember, say, I'm Kevin Cedar. Call me if you have any questions. That's it. That's how we end the video. Okay, keep going. I'm sorry.
What also happens is that you have different types of relationships in today's society, and therefore couples take all types of shapes and sizes and forms as well. Therefore, when there is any type of domestic violence, it's going to happen in all types of different ways. What truly is harmful, though, is the fact that children are involved in relationships with adults and have viewed or heard such domestic violence. That is not healthy for a child. And when that happens, DCF becomes involved. An example of this would be where the police show up at your home. Neighbor calls, or family member calls, or perhaps one of the intimate partners calls, 911. The police come, and if somebody's been doing drugs or is impaired due to alcohol, the police usually arrest that person. And then they call DCF if there's children involved. Then DCF will come out and speak to the other partner, get their side of the story. And if the children heard or saw or involved in any way, shape, or form with this domestic violence situation, DCF will do an investigation into the facts surrounding this domestic violence. In the end, the department may or may not support it for what is called neglect. Not giving minimal supervision. Children must have a sober caretaker, or one that's not influenced by drugs or alcohol. Also, a child should have an intimate adult, a parent, that is not involved in control or coercion or domestic violence. And that this has adverse effects, according to the case law, on children who have been victimized by viewing such domestic violence. When you're involved with a domestic violence situation, you should seek a restraining order so that you are protected by the courts. So you use the restraining order as a shield. And I know generalization is that usually it's male on female. That's just completely false. There are situations where there are females that harm males. The predominant factors are that males usually are the ones that have abused the females, unfortunately. But there are all types of relationships. There are gay, there are straight relationships, there's LGBT, there's all types of couples. There's bisexual couples, there's lesbian couples, there's homosexual couples, there's all types of couples in our society. There are people that are married, there are people that are unmarried. So it varies from couple to couple to couple. But what doesn't vary is the effects that domestic violence has on children. it can be tumultuous. It can be very, very, very traumatizing. And there's where DCF comes in, to protect children and make sure that children are not abused and neglected or involved in domestic violence situations that can truly impact and make a difference in a negative way, which would be neglect in a child's life. If you like this video, please share it with someone that you know that's in trouble, has issues, or legal challenges with DCF. Thank you.